Welcome to the Electricity of Life, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. The electric universe and plasma cosmology have laid the foundations for a new understanding of our sun and of all stars. Many decades ago, the father of plasma cosmology, the Nobel Prize winner Hannes Alfvén, proposed that stars form electromagnetically along vast networks of filaments, like pearls on a string. Later, the electrical engineer Ralph Jurgens went a step further and developed an electrical model of the sun as an anode, a positively charged body powered by galactic electric currents. In the last year, the project scientists with the independent Sapphire experiment announced a series of findings in agreement with the electric sun model. Indeed, we learn more every day about the extraordinary electromagnetic connection between our planet and its parent star, including the discovery in 2014 that powerful outbursts from the sun result in increased lightning on Earth. Perhaps even more remarkably, a number of scientific papers have reported an apparent correlation between surprising changes in radioactive decay rates and solar activity. But not only does our planet and all of its complex atmospheric systems share a remarkable relationship with the sun, so too is all of life affected by the sun in ways that science has only begun to recognize. And here, the electrical nature of the sun shines through with striking clarity. Consider the recent scientific discovery of a surprising correlation between solar storms and the beaching of gray whales and certain other cetacean species. The apparent connection was originally noted by a biologist and his team at Duke University, who found that when dark sunspots cover the sun, the marine mammals are more likely to beach themselves. With the help of an astronomer, they were able to confirm the connection. Their findings have been published in the journal Current Biology in the paper "Gray Whales Strand More Often on Days with Increased Levels of Atmospheric Radio Frequency Noise." The paper's abstract states that the findings suggest, quote, "the potential for magnetoreception in this species." In fact, this is not the first scientific paper to demonstrate such a correlation. In 2016, Cambridge University's International Journal of Astrobiology published the paper, "Solar Storms May Trigger Sperm Whale Strandings." The authors state in the paper's abstract, "Magnetic fields can affect terrestrial life, such as migrating animals. Thus, terrestrial life is connected to astronomical interrelations between different magnetic fields, particle flows, and radiation. Whales' magnetic sense may play an important role in orientation and migration, and strandings may thus be triggered by geomagnetic storms." Of course, the concept of magnetoreception in some animals is not new. Many biologists have long proposed that the mysterious abilities of homing pigeons is resolved by the presence of magnetic particles in the pigeons' heads. This apparent magnetic sensing has also been found in other animals, perhaps surprisingly, including cattle. As reported in a study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, USA, in 2008, we demonstrate that domestic cattle across the globe and grazing and resting red and roe deer align their body axes in roughly a north-south direction. Direct observations of roe deer revealed that animals orient their heads northward when grazing or resting. Amazingly, this ubiquitous phenomenon does not seem to have been noticed by herdsmen, ranchers, or hunters. Other species that seem sensitive to Earth's magnetic field include frogs, lobsters, snails, and perhaps most intriguingly of all, humans. While a human magnetic sense has long been a subject of interest and investigation, the most powerful scientific evidence to date came in 2019 with the publication of the paper "Transduction of the Geomagnetic Field as Evidence from Alpha Band Activity in the Human Brain." In the experiment, conducted by a team of Caltech scientists, 34 subjects sat in an aluminum box which shielded them from electromagnetic noise. The box was lined with coils through which electric currents flowed, and the investigators created a magnetic field which sloped downward, similar to the geomagnetic field at the mid-latitudes of the northern hemisphere. They then rotated the field, producing a measurable change in the brain activity of nearly one-third of the study's participants. In an article in Science magazine, biologist Margaret Ahmad states of the findings, "I'm not surprised there's an effect. There's something in a cell that is different in the presence of a magnetic field. We see this effect in human embryonic kidney cells. You're not going to convince me that an effect in brain cells is of any greater or lesser significance. And here, the great significance of the electromagnetic connection between the Sun and the Earth comes into focus. The Earth is a rotating, charged body, and electric currents from the Sun touch down at the Earth's poles, producing the aurorae and modifying our planet's magnetic field. Evidence of the profound biological effects of both electric and magnetic fields increases with each passing year. So the question is, do geomagnetic events impact the physiology of human beings? Increasingly, it seems the answer is yes. In fact, it was over a century ago that the Soviet-era scientist Alexander Chizhevsky founded the field of heliobiology, the study of the sun's effect on biology. As noted in an earlier Electricity of Life by Alex Fournier, Chizhevsky conducted exhaustive data analysis, which compared solar activity with prominent historical events in human society. Using a, quote, mass excitability index, Chizhevsky found that the timing of these prominent events consistently linked to outbursts from the sun, which led Chizhevsky to propose that geomagnetic storms had a significant impact on the human mind and behavior. As the result of his scientific endeavor, after refusing to retract his findings, he was placed in a labor gulag for 8 years by Soviet leader Joseph Stalin. Today, scientific research into the sun's effects on the human body and mind continues, with an emphasis on the role of electromagnetism. For example, a number of studies have reported data suggesting a connection between geomagnetic storms and dramatic changes in blood pressure and other effects on the heart. And as suggested by earlier research, some scientists have found an apparent linkage between geomagnetic storms and major changes in behavior. In 2006, the peer-reviewed journal Bioelectromagnetics published the paper, "Do Ambient Electromagnetic Fields Affect Behavior? A Demonstration of the Relationship Between Geomagnetic Storm Activity and Suicide." The authors studied the geomagnetic storm activity and the national suicide statistics for Australia between the years 1968 and 2002. Their conclusion was that the data, quote, suggests that perturbations in ambient electromagnetic field activity impact behavior in a clinically meaningful manner. In February of 2020, another study, this time focusing on suicide statistics in Taiwan, reported similar results. Such findings might sound strange, but the purpose of this series is to explore the role of electricity in nature and biology, including the body's electrical circuitry. In fact, the connection between major health changes and geomagnetic activity might actually be predictable in light of the remarkable scientific research of our previous guest, Dr. Jerry Tennant. Dr. Tennant has proposed that many health problems are essentially the result of a disruption of the natural voltage in the body's muscles and organs. Emotions, Dr. Tennant suggests, are stored in and around our bodies in the form of magnetic fields. The treatment he's devised involves the use of other magnetic fields and scalar energy to restore the body's voltage and, quote, erase the residual effects of trauma. In describing the relationship between celestial objects and the greater cosmos, we have stated that no islands exist in our electric universe. Of course, this applies not only to astronomical objects, but to all of life. And thus, it is unsurprising that the evidence of the electrical nature of the cosmos continues to illuminate the interconnectedness of all things.